Hello, I'm Saukki, and today I'm going to do another speed test with the racing hood. Actually, I've tested this already. I made this speed test video a few years ago, but in that video, that wasn't very scientific test. I just tried on my basic training route, and I didn't have any power meter, so I was just going full speed. So I have no idea if that was any accurate. And I only made one run with the racing hood, so that wasn't very accurate test. But now I have a power meter, so I'm going to do better test this time. First I'm going to ride without racing hood, then I'm going to also test the mini visor and also this foam cover, because this is the standard cover for your Velomobile. So let's go. Okay, the test setup is this. I have two cameras, one there and one here. So this will be on all the time. Foot holes are open and there are no wheel covers. Because in last test video I found out that there's not much difference. Okay, so all tests are done now. Actually I didn't feel any big difference, so I think that the test road is this time a little bit shorter. Only about 1 kilometer, and this is maybe the flattest part of this road, so that's why I'm testing on this piece. Okay, so first the standard setting, no any covers on here on manhole, so let's go. Okay, so this is how the test will go. I accelerate to 45 kilometers per hour and then try to keep the speed steady at 45 for the 1 kilometer long test piece, and the test piece starts here. I press the lap button at start and end of this test piece, and now I just try to keep the speed steady at 45. And the end is here. Okay, so that was one 0.9 kilometers long test piece. Now let's just repeat this a few times. I think that maybe 3 times is enough. Now let's go put the mini visor on. And then after this, I think we should get smaller power reading, so let's see. Okay, now I have the mini visor, so let's do the same tests. And here we go to the first lap. In my last test a few years ago, there was few percent difference in speed in favor for this mini visor, so let's see if we get few percent difference also here. So maybe I just used a few percent less power for this lap than without this mini visor, so. But I don't know, we have to see the results later. And that's it. That was the 3 runs for the mini visor. Next, let's go get the foam cover. Okay, now I have the foam cover, and this should be the easiest and cheapest way to make your Velomobile faster. As I said in that video, how to make your Velomobile faster.
Okay, then the last item on my top 5 list, the huge opening here. As you can see, this large hole makes a lot of drag, and then your head is sticking out of there. And his next hack is probably the easiest and cheapest one. Okay, as you can see, this cover covers almost the whole opening, and you probably already have this cover, because this cover always comes with the Velomobile.
So now with this, we should see big difference in power compared to the first tests with open top. So this should be very interesting. Okay, the difference should be so big that I should see it right away. And yes, it sure is. Right away I can see that there's big difference. Maybe 20 or 30 watts or something. But of course I have to check the accurate results later when I get back to my computer. But it really looks like there's big difference. So I was right when I said that this is the cheapest and easiest way to make your Velomobile faster. But I still have to do few more laps. Okay, that's it. 3 tests with the foam cover. Next, let's go get the racing hood. That one should be the fastest one. Okay, now I don't have the helmet on, but the camera is still on top of the racing hood. Okay, so this should be the fastest option, but it's also heaviest. But I think that in this test, the weight isn't an issue because the test piece of road is it's flat, so weight difference shouldn't affect the results. And here we go. Yes, this definitely feels fastest. I think this feels even faster than the foam cover. And I hope we see the same thing in the results. Okay, few more rounds and then let's go see the results. Okay, all testing done for today. Now let's go see the results. That should be very interesting.
Okay, I have the data again here in Strava. And because I started a new lap for every test run, we can use the lap data from Strava. And here the laps 2, 4, 6 and so on are the test runs. And same thing than with the wheel cover tests, we are now interested about the power readings. The speed was same through the whole test. And now we can collect the power data to one spreadsheet. And let's also take note of the speed, so we can be sure that the average speed was about the same in all test runs. And here are the results for the open top runs. I made one extra run because I felt that the first run was too fast, but the data shows that it wasn't too much faster, so we can include that run as well. There is slight variation in the power readings. Here we have 11 watts between the highest and the lowest power reading. So I guess the error in these results might be as high as 5 or 6 watts. And we can see similar amount of variation in the other results as well. During the test the weather was pretty windy, so I think most of these variations are because of the wind. Here on the bottom line I have the averages of the first test runs. Let's use this as a control and compare the other results to this one, because the open top configuration is the standard one out of the box. Then the mini visor. Here is also slight variation between the power readings. But the average is 11 watts less than the control. Here are the results for the foam cover. Here we can see big difference. And I was able to feel this difference during the test.
Big difference. Maybe 20 or 30 watts or something.
And the difference really is 30 watts. Then the racing hood. And this really is the most efficient configuration. Only 141 watts, which is 45 watts less than control. Here you can quickly see how much more efficient these different configurations are compared to the control. Here we can see that mini visor is 5% more efficient and the racing hood is 24% more efficient. But okay, I think that's all for today. Please subscribe and also visit my webshop and buy something. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.